Shalom. Good day, everyone.
Shalom. 平安。大家好。
Let us start with two Bible promises in Psalm 84.
让我们从诗篇圣经的两个应许开始。
Verse 4, Blessed are they that dwell in thy house. They will be still praising thee, Selah.
84篇第四节。如此住在你殿中的便为有福，他们仍要赞美你，希拉。
Verse 7, They go from strength to strength, every one of them in Zion appeared before God.
第七节，他们行走力上加力，个人到西安朝见神。
Someone has said, every Christian should have at least two homelands, the land of his birth and the Holy Land.
有人说过，每一个基督徒至少应当有两个家乡，一个是他的出生地，另外一个就是圣地。
For this reason, we believe every Christian should go to the Holy Land, if possible, at least once in his or her lifetime.
为了这个原因，我们相信每个基督徒都应当去圣地，可能的话，至少一生中去一次。
There in Bible lands, we will walk where Jesus walked.And see how Bible events had occurred in that land of miracles.
在那圣经的土地上，我们走在耶稣曾经走过的路上，看到圣经的事迹重新的在这个充满了神迹的土地上发生。
And we would feel God's presence with us and see the Bible come alive.
我们会感受到神的同在，也看到圣经活出来。
Praise God, last year in 2011,We had 200 members in four buses.
感谢神，在去年2011年，我们有四辆车，有超过200个的会员。
This year, we have about the same number of members.
今年我们有差不多同样数目的会员。
From the USA, Canada, the Philippines, China, and Taiwan.
会从美国、加拿大、菲律宾、中国和台湾。
Our Holy Land tour.Start in Amman, Jordan.
我们圣地的旅游从约旦的安曼开始。
And brings us all over that ancient land of the sunrise, the land east of the Jordan River.
带我们走到这个东方日出之地的古代的地方，走遍全地就是约旦河东面的地方。
From east to west,
从东到西。
And from south to the north.
从南到北。
Then we go to northern Galilee.
然后我们去到加利利的北部。
Where Jesus had spent most of his lifetime on earth.
那是主耶稣在地上的时候花很多时间在的地方。
Then down the Mediterranean coast we go.
然后我们沿着地中海的海岸下去。
And then...We entered Jerusalem, the golden city.
进入那个黄金的城，耶路撒冷。
After many days in Jerusalem,
在耶路撒冷许多天以后，
where Jesus had preached, taught, was crucified, resurrected, and is coming again.
也就是耶稣曾经在那里讲道、教导、被钉、复活、再来的地方。
The tour goes down south.To Jericho.
我们旅游团向南走到耶利哥。
The Dead Sea.
死海。
And then the Red Sea.
还有红海。
Following that, we go out of Israel and the bus drives through the Sinai Peninsula.
让我们离开以色列，我们的车会经过西奈半岛。
And to Mount Sinai.
然后去西奈山。
Then, from there we go northwest through the desert and cross the Suez Canal.
从那里我们往西北走，经过沙漠，过苏伊士运河。
Finally, we come to Cairo and the pyramids.
最后我们来到开罗，还有金字塔的地方。
During this two-week tour, we will visit over 120 different sites.
在这两个星期的旅游，我们会参观超过120个地方。
All relating to the Bible.
都是与圣经有关的。
This is a Bible study tour.
这是一个圣经学习的旅游。
With lots of fun and fellowship time among members.
我们也有许多的交通和欢愉的时间在我们的团员之间。
We're praying for each other, helping each other.
我们会彼此的带导，彼此的帮助。
The weather will be very nice. It is springtime there.
天气会非常好，那当时当地是春天。
So wear comfortable clothes and walking shoes.
所以穿比较舒服的衣裳，还有穿那个预备走路的鞋。
Every day, our program starts at 8 a.m. when the bus would start going.
每天早上，我们的汽车会八点钟，早上八点出发。
Before that is wake up call at 6 a.m.
早上六点就起床。
From 6 to 8 in the morning is free time for your morning preparations, personal devotions, and breakfast.
六点到八点是自由时间，也是你自己个人的准备、灵修和早餐的时间。
Listed in this devotional schedule.
那有关这个唱的特别诗歌等等，都是在那个灵修的日程上面。
Then, we have several devotions. One of them in Mount Nebo.
那我们这个短的灵修呢，有个地方，比如好像尼泊山，
Capernaum，
加布农。
Petra，
彼得拉
，Sea of Galilee， Beatitudes，
加利利海，巴夫山
，Cana， Nazareth，
加拿，拿撒勒
，Megiddo， Mount Carmel，
米基多，加米山
，Joppa， The Pyramids，
约帕，还有塔。
We would also have devotions near the Dead Sea。
我们在死海边上也会有这个灵修。
In Jerusalem, devotions in the Via Dolorosa.
当然，耶路撒冷十架道。
Gethsemane, the Garden Tomb.
科西玛尼园，花园墓。
Bethlehem, Mount Sinai.
伯利恒，西乃山。
And many other places.
还有许多的地方。
By short devotions, we mean 15 minutes of singing, Bible reading, prayer, and a short lecture.
短的灵修时间，我们的意思就是大概有15分钟的唱诗、读经、祷告和短讲。
Let us bring out two highlights of the daytime devotions.
我们介绍一下两个早上白天灵修的时间。
The first is baptism in the Jordan River.
一个就是在约旦河受洗。
Here, members are requested. Members can request to be baptized.
在这里呢，会员可以请求受浸
，either for the first time or for rededication.
可以是第一次，或者是重新的决志
，either with full immersion.
也可以是全身的受浸
，or just feet only.
光是只是脚也可以。
It's very meaningful to follow Jesus, even as we are in Galilee near the Jordan River, as he was baptized near that area.
当我们在约旦河边，我们可以效法耶稣的榜样，因为主耶稣也在那个地区受浸。
Highlight, daytime highlight is upper room communion.
另外一个特别要注意的地方就是在马可楼。
There in Jerusalem's upper room, we would have the Holy Communion.
在那个耶路撒冷的马可楼上面，我们会守圣餐。
We would use the olive cups, which members may keep as souvenir.
我们有个橄榄形的杯子，是各位可以保留带为纪念的。
There, Jesus and his disciples started the Holy Communion during the Last Supper.
就是那里，主耶稣和他的门徒守最后的晚餐。
And there, 50 days after Christ ascended to heaven, the Holy Spirit descended on the disciples.
同样地方，也主升天以后50天圣灵降临的地方。
Let's look at our buses.
那现在看看我们的旅游车。
These are deluxe tourist buses.
这些都是豪华旅游车。
You will enjoy the ride.
你会坐得很舒服。
And the beautiful scenery.
也可以欣赏美丽的风景。
Both inside and outside the bus.
在车内车外都非常美丽。
Please follow the bus seating chart.
请各位跟着这个巴士的座位表。
And advance one row forward every day.
每一天向前移一排。
The first three rows are reserved for Bible teachers, bus leaders, and special needs members.
最前面三排是保留给那个圣经的教师和这个司机，还有特别有需要的会员。
Now let us look at our hotels.
那现在看看我们的旅馆。
These are mostly four-star and five-star hotels.
这些大部分都是四星级、五星级的旅馆。
They have very nice rooms, beautiful views, many with swimming pools.
他们很好的房间，很好的风景，还有许多含有游泳池。
For example, the Dead Sea Hotel is right near the Dead Sea.
比如说，在死海区的旅馆，它是非常靠近死海。
And even have Dead Sea water available inside the hotel swimming pool.
旅馆里面的游泳池甚至有从死海引进来的水。
However, the hotel in Mount Sinai has no star.
不过，这个西奈的旅馆却是无星级。
But many stars at night in the sky.
不过天上却有许多的星星。
But it is the best there is at Sinai.
但是这个是西奈能够提供的最好的地方。
And it even has a little swimming pool.
甚至还有一个很小型的游泳池。
Now, since these are good hotels,
既然这些是好的旅馆，
they have very good food and meals for breakfast and for dinner.
所以呢，早饭、晚饭都是非常优良。
For lunchtime, we are out on the road. Visiting the sites.
当然是在白天的时候，我们是在外出了。
So we hope you enjoy yourself, and most members even gain weight during the tour.
希望你能够尽情的享受。那我们大部分的团员呢，通常都会加磅。
While in the hotel at night, we have optional evening service.
在晚上在旅馆的时候，我们有些可以选择性的自由参加的一些的聚会。
These are about 45 minutes.
这些差不多是45分钟一次。
Our Bible teachers will speak on these interesting topics.
我们圣经的教师们他们会讲一些很令人兴奋的圣经的题目。
Such as Bible historical geography.
比如说圣经的历史地理
The Tabernacle
会幕
An overview of the Book of Revelation
还有启示录的大纲
The Temple
圣殿
Introduction to Jerusalem
耶路撒冷的介绍
Ancient Egypt
古埃及
Testimony time and other programs
有见证的时间还有其他的项目
There will also be short preview and review of the placesVisited that day and the next day.
我们有一些简短的介绍预告，就是有关当天我们要去到的地方和明天去的地方。
In this regard, there will be two very important evening events.
还有两个非常重要特别的晚上的节目。
Please do not miss it.
请你万万不要失去这个机会。
A Passover Last Supper presentation.
第一个就是逾越节晚餐的一个节目
held right in our hotel in Jerusalem.
会在耶路撒冷的旅馆里面举行
Show how Jesus instituted the Holy Communion during the Last Supper in Jerusalem.
我们会示范主耶稣当时在耶路撒冷最后晚餐的时候，他是怎么样设立这个圣餐的。
Past Jewish Passover ceremony, Jesus took the second bread and the third cup of the ceremony.
在那个时候，主耶稣拿起了第二个杯， 和饼
and started the Holy Communion.
就开始了这个圣餐。
Sometimes the ingredients must be inspected by the hotel's rabbi.
有的时候这个圣餐的用具的 食品要经过旅馆的拉比检查。
Because we had announced it as Passover.
因为我们告诉他们这个是逾越节。
The second evening event
第二个在晚上的节目
would be a visit to the Western Wall Tunnel.
就是会参观那个西墙的隧道。
This is a very popular and newly opened site located under the Wailing Wall.
这个就在哭墙下面，这个是最新开始，也是非常受欢迎的地方。
We will walk the ancient streets of Jesus times 2,000 years ago.
我们走上耶稣时代2000年前的古代的街道上。
And we will see stones that are over 100 tons used in building the temple by Solomon.
我们会看到所罗门当时建造圣殿所用的石块，大概每一块是超过100吨。
Now, let's talk about what Bible books should we read to prepare for the tour.
现在我们讲一讲，来看看有些什么圣经的经卷，我们为了这个旅游来读的。
To get the fullest benefit of your investment in this pilgrimage.
我尽量的利用到我们在这个自己圣地旅游各位的投资。
You want to be familiar with the Bible itself.
你最好是能够对圣经本身有一些熟悉。
Before the tour, please read three Bible books as follows.
在旅程没有开始之前，请你先读三本圣经的书。
The first book is the Gospel of Mark.
第一本就是马可福音。
This book tells about the life of Christ in 16 dramatic chapters.
这本书会告诉我们耶稣生平用了16章非常戏剧性的章。
You will be inspired when reading this gospel.
你会得到很大的灵感。
Most of the places we will visit in the Holy Land tour will relate to the events in the life of Christ.
在圣地我们参观许多的地方都是和耶稣生平有关的。
The second book to read is the book of Genesis.
第二本要读的书就是创世纪。
Especially chapters 12 to 40.
特别是第12章到第40章。
It starts with how God called Abraham.
那里讲到神怎么样呼召亚伯拉罕。
He was the first of the Jewish people.
他是犹太人的先祖。
It describes Abraham's son Isaac.
那里描写到亚伯拉罕的儿子以撒。
His grandson Jacob.
他的孙子雅各。
And his great grandson Joseph, who was sold into Egypt.
也还有他的被卖到埃及做奴隶的曾孙约瑟。
The third book we hope you would read is the book of Exodus.
第三本需要读的书，希望你读的书就是出埃及记。
At least cover chapters 1 to 20.
至少从第一章读到第二十章。
Because we go to Egypt and the Sinai Peninsula.
因为我们要去埃及，也去到西奈半岛。
You will want to read first about how the Israelites were found in Egypt.
首先你要读到为什么以色列人会下去埃及。
And why they had to leave Egypt in the Exodus.
然后为什么要出埃及。
And what happened on their way back to the promised land.
那他们回到应许之地之前发生什么事情。
Transiting at Mount Sinai for 1 year.
停留在西乃山有一年。
So therefore, first read these three Bible books.
所以首先请读这三本书。
The Gospel of Mark 1 to 16 chapters.
马可福音第一章到十六章。
Genesis chapters 12 to 40.
创世纪十二章到四十章。
And Exodus chapters 1 to 20.
出埃及记一章到二十章。
Finally, let's talk about the safety and security issue.
最后我们讲一讲我们安全的措施。
When we register to join the Holy Land tour,
当我们 登记参加这个圣地旅游团。
It is because of our faith and trust in God.
是因为我们相信神。
And God's promises.
和相信神的应许。
Christ is the author and finisher of our faith.
主耶稣是我们信心创始成终者。
What he started, he will complete.
他开始的，他必会完成。
He will guide and protect us as we go to his land.
当我们进入他的地土地的时候，他必定会带领也保护我们。
But we also must realize that there will always be uncertainty and unrest in the Middle East.
但是我们必须也要理解到，当时一定会有一些不定，还有一些不安，尤其是中东这个地区。
The Bible predicted it and called it signs of the times.
正如圣经曾经预告过，这个称为时代的预兆。
The safety and security of our members will always be top priority in our tour.
在我们旅程中，我们团员们的安全跟保安是我们首先要注意的。
We will not knowingly go to areas that are sensitive or dangerous.
我们绝对不会在我们知道的情形底下进入那些比较敏感或者危险的地区。
We only go to visit biblical and archaeological sites.
我们只去有关圣经的和有关考古的地区。
And these are usually not affected by unrest.
这些通常都不会有受到治安问题的影响。
Actually, Israel on the average is just as safe as any city, big city in America.
实际上，以色列一般来说，它有像美国的任何城市一样的安全。
However, always remember that you are in the Middle East.
不过，请你常常记住，你的确在中东。
And take proper precautions accordingly.
那为此，你要小心预备一些事情。
In the Middle East, the streets are ancient and crooked.
中东的街道比较古老而且弯曲。
So always be with your own group.
所以请你不要离团。
Do not go out alone.
千万不要自己一个人出去。
Let your companion know where you are at all times.
随时随地告诉你其他的队员们你在哪里。
Even if just to the washroom.
甚至只是要去洗手间。
We may be 100 members,
也许我们有100个人,
but do not be the 100 sheep, the number 100 sheep that went astray.
但千万不要做那个第一百只迷失的羊。
Stick with the 99 sheep,
与99个羊在一起。
We also have contingency plans.
我们也有一些特别的计划。
In case a place or an airport is closed,
假如某一个地方或者某一个机场是关闭,
we will change our routing accordingly.
我们会改变我们的行程。
And our agency will help you in your outgoing flight.
我们的旅行社他们会帮助我们做的起飞各样的事情。
Our agency is one of the largest in the Middle East.
我们的旅行社是在中东里面大的一间。
They have experience in taking care of thousands of tourists.
他们照顾过成千的会员，所以他们这一方面很有经验。
And they give us good service because we go every year.
他们也为我们提供很好的服务，因为我们每年都跟他去。
This past 20 years, I have been to Israel over 30 times.
在过去二十年，我差不多去了以色列三十次。
And we always use the best possible travel agency.
我们都常常用最好的旅行社。
With proven good services.
他们有被证明过的、保证有的好的服务。
Also, tourism is the number one industry of Israel.
况且在以色列，这个旅游业是他们第一等。的工业。
It's number two industry in Egypt.
在埃及是第二名的工业。
Following the Suez Canal, income from Suez Canal.
跟着 是紧接着苏伊士运河的收入而来。
And so the governments protect tourists at all costs.
因此这些政府都尽量绝对尽量的保护 旅行者的安全。
Nevertheless, we trust in the Lord.
但是我们相信的是主。
And remember Psalms 121.
请记得诗篇121篇。
It is the traveler's psalm.
我们称它为旅行者的诗篇。
Verse 1 says, A song of degrees, I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills, from whence cometh my help.
这第一节上行之诗，我要向山举目，我的帮助从何而来？
The Lord, verse 5, The Lord is thy keeper, the Lord is thy shield upon thy right hand.
第五节，保护你的是耶和华，耶和华在你右边荫庇你。
Verse 7, The Lord shall protect thee from all evil, he shall preserve thy soul.
第七节，耶和华要保护你免受一切的灾害，他要保护你的性命。
Verse 8, The Lord shall preserve thy going out and thy coming in.
第八节，你出你入，耶和华要保护你。
From this time forth and even forevermore.
从今时直到永远。
Thank you so much, and God bless you.
谢谢各位，愿神祝福你们。